President of the United States.
The dedication and the spirit of our nation's civil servants. The granting of presidential rank awards provides the opportunity to recognize a select group of these employees for extraordinary service. America is passing into a new era, reversing a long trend of government expansion. I'm going to clear my throat. Limit what it does, yet still perform its rightful task with utmost skill and professionalism. Meeting this difficult challenge will require the determination and imagination which this year's rank award recipients have amply demonstrated. There are 6,500 federal employees in the senior executive service, and this year only 25 were selected to receive this distinguished executive award. These men being honored for the contributions they've made during their careers as public servants. Over the years, they've maintained a level of accomplishment head and shoulders above many other fellows. While their talents have long been recognized by those with whom they work, this award gives us the opportunity to thank them in the name of the people of the United States for the benefits of their diligence. There is a small stipend that accompanies this award, yet it in no way represents the enormous sums they have saved the taxpayers. Looking over their backgrounds, I was impressed beyond words at the services they've performed. Some excelled in science or engineering projects, saving tax dollars by designing equipment that works well. In the case of Henry Harris, he developed a new weapons system of joint logistics that will be of considerable savings. This is an extraordinary list. Clyde Jeffcoat, for example, designed an accounting and billing system that eliminates the need for thousands of employees and saves millions of dollars. Better than focusing on new construction, Peter Kim led an effort to upgrade current housing units and promote a self-help program for the youth's underprivileged occupants. And David Minotti was a remarkable record mediated difficult conflicts between the EPA, industry, and environmental groups. Time won't permit me to detail all of their accomplishments, but let me just say that we're very proud to have all of you working with us. And for the people of this country, I offer you a word. Thank you, and well done. I should turn it over to you. Thank you.
Mr. President, I am proud as your chief bureaucrat and director of your civil service to honor 25 outstanding government executives who express the true degree of patriotism by proving their commitment to the country every day as they've carried out their assignments for the public over their long periods of service. As you mentioned, the decade of the 80s presents new challenges, and we very much need the support of all our civil servants. As you said in your acceptance speech, and probably the only time a politician has done this in an acceptance speech, you asked for the ideas and the efforts of federal employees to help you make government work. Through the 98-year history of the civil service, you haven't been let down, and these 25 have responded in an extraordinary way to show that their support is with you and the country as we make these changes. So, Mr. President, I'd like to present to you these 25 truly outstanding civil servants. First, Alan G. Forsell, Director of Surface Ship Systems Command, Department of the Navy. Second, Henry R. Harris, Deputy Project Manager, U.S. Army Missile Command, Department of the Army. Donald P. Harth, Director, Langley Research Center, National Aeronautics and Space Administration. Jimmy D. Hill, Director, Office of Space Systems, Assistant Secretary for Housing, Department of Housing and Urban Development. Clyde E. Jeffco, Deputy Commander, Army Finance and Accounting Center, Department of the Army. Peter M. Kim, Director, Office of Housing, Agency for International Development. Lester P. Lim, Executive Director, Federal Highway Administration, Department of Transportation. R. Kenneth Lobb, Technical Director, Naval Air Development Center, Department of the Navy. John W. Lyons, Director, National Engineering Laboratory, National Bureau of Standards, Department of Commerce. David G. Matheson, Chief Fiscal Analysis Branch, Office of Management and Budget. Harold A. McGulfin, Regional Commissioner, Internal Revenue Service, Department of Treasury. David E. Minotti, Associate General Counsel for Air, Noise and Radiation, Environmental Protection Agency. Robert L. Morgan, Manager, Savannah River Operations Office, Department of Energy. Frederick T. Rowell, Jr., Technical Director, Aeronautical Systems Division, Department of Air Force. Glenn Allen Rudd, Director of Security Assistance Operations Defense Security Agency, Department of Defense. Richard G. Smith, Director, John F. Kennedy Space Center, National Aeronautics and Space Administration. William L. Smith, Administrator for Overseas Schools, Department of Education. Joseph H. Sherrick, Deputy Assistant Secretary for Program and Budget, Department of Defense. Earl R. Stathman couldn't be here receiving the honor as Thomas E. Malone, Health and Human Services Department. Henning von Gerke couldn't be here today either, I'm sorry to say. Next is William C. Watson, Jr., Deputy Director, Center for Disease Control, Department of Health and Human Services. Army J. Wilcox, General Counsel, Department